Dr. Nagesh, physician in EMS. I would like to do a respiratory system examination on you. Is it okay for you?
Yes.
Before I start, can I know your name and birthday, please?
My name is Go. My birthday is 12 December 1995.
Hello. Can you please take off your shirt?
Sure.
Since I have to examine your respiratory system.
Sure.
I would like to do a general examination on you, okay? There is no cyanosis, no clubbing, pulse is regular, okay? Thrapping tremors, do straight ahead to yourself, yeah. No flapping tremors are seen, okay, and no LR, so your tongue, no central sinuses, no cervical glands felt anywhere, no posterior as well as no anterior cervical glands, no discharging sinuses seen. AVP seems to be normal. Before concluding, I would like to also see for the Horner syndrome pupils, because the TB and malignancies are the most common disorders in respiratory system. So look for the evidence of these two things in the general examination. Okay. No edema of feet. Okay. Now we come to how to do respiratory system examination. This is a local respiratory examination. General, we have already finished. Okay. Now, on inspection, we have to see any bony abnormalities like in the spine and chest. There is no bony abnormalities like any prominent rosette, raspberry or vitamin D deficiency. There is no sulcus hiatus or there is no Harrison sulcus, no pectus cavitus, no pigeon chest, no abnormalities in the chest front. There are no pulsations seen. No rachia. Both the sternomastoid ends are seen equally. No prominence of any particular sternomastoid or trail sign is negative. Trachea appears to be central on inspection. The apex impulse is not quite visually seen. Let us come to the palpation. The apex beat is in the fifth intercostal space, medial to the mid-clavicle line. No peristaltic heave, no diastolic shock. The movements of the both chest, pharyngeal nerves, movements of the chest is bilaterally equal. The trachea seems to be central. Most of the both the lungs are resonant. Good note, except the liver area and the cardiac dullness will be dull. We start from top second space. So at the fifth intercostal space, it becomes dull and the liver dullness starts down. The cardiac dullness is around on the left side to space 3 and 4, around that is the cardiac dullness. The top space is more splenic area, most of the time it is resonant because of the stomach gas. It is lost in pleural effusion and it becomes very dull in pleural effusion and splenic enlargement. The liver dullness increases whenever there is liver pathology. Hepatomegaly, liver abscess, subplenic abscesses, etc. So, percussion, tactile fluorometer, you check like this. Say 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3. Tectile femoris is equal on both sides. Now we start auscultation. Okay. Take deep breath. 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 Deep breath. So on auscultation, the bilateral air entry is good. Good expansion, no bronchi, no crepitations, there is no bronchial breathing, no added sounds, no abnormal sounds like eugophony, whispering pectorally. When I say, you please say 1, 2, 3, okay? Say 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3. 1,
2, 3. Now we come to the back. On inspection, we have to first think, is there any kyphoscoliosis? So, bony abnormality, there is no bony abnormality. Is there any drooping of any shoulders? They are at the same level. No particular shoulder is going down to suggest any fibrosis. There is no crowding of the ribs seen anywhere. Bilateral expansion seems to be good. Say, deep breath, take deep breath, out, take deep breath. So bilateral expansion is very good, symmetric. We go to palpation, okay? Take deep breath. Take the breath, take out completely. Take out completely. Take the breath, take out completely. Take the breath, take out completely. Take the breath, take out completely. Take the breath. So bilateral chest expansion is very good. Say 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
By here we come to the percussion. Percussion, you find out the spine and both the sides first. Percuss, it will be normal note. Only in case of severe pleural effusion, you can have a dull note there. Also percuss the supra scapular area, interscapular area, and then one by one go down. So there will be, if spleen enlarged, there will be dullness, otherwise will be resonant. On the right side there will be low down will be hepatic dullness. Okay, take the breath. Take deep breath, take deep breath, take deep breath, take deep breath, deep breath, take 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 deep breath. So what on auscultation what we have to see is whether bilateral air entry is good. So air entry in this patient is good bilaterally. There is no reduced air entry anywhere. There is no the vesicular breathing bilaterally. No signs of any bronchial breathing anywhere down to suggest any consolidation. There is no added sounds like eugophony, whispering pectorally. Okay, it is not seen. No evidence of any pleural effusion. No evidence of pneumothorax and bilateral signs are equally good.